Kids Workshop. So today is a whole new episode, and we will make jewelry. And first I will show you what we will make from down here, or maybe we can take it from, is it easier to see over here? No, it's the right camera. So sorry, I made this little box here, and in here we have this little, we'll go to the camera and hope it can, focus on it. I think I have set it to manual focus, so I think we will put, fix that later. But like this. So I have put a little plastic bag inside here. And you will open that. Put that one up there. So, as you can see, I will do it down here on the white. Shift to this one, and then you go down a little. It's very hard to focus with the wobbly stuff. But as you can see, it's made it's made of ebony, and ebony and a copper insert, but we'll come to that. Ebony is three like this one, and but it's kind of a different sort of tree. It's totally black, and it's not painted or anything. It's like that in the nature. And the difference between this tree and nearly all other trees is that this one will not float. It will drop down to the bottom because it's so dense. So don't build a boat up of it. But and it's kind of like hard, like metal, but it gets really nice when you polish it. Oops. Like kind of it feels like plastic or something, but it isn't. And the idea is that this one is with a copper insert, and the next one, the one we will make with something white like this one, they call it camel bone, but I don't know if it ever have seen a camel inside or outside. I don't know what it is, bone of some kind, and maybe it's from a camel, I don't know. And ebony you can get from hobby store there that sells stuff to knife handles, what shall we call it, hunter's knife, the handle they often use something ebony in, and and you can get them. This ebony is from it's from southern India and western Africa and Sri Lanka. There this grows, and it's native to those country, but not up here north. And you can think it's a very slow growing stuff because it's a hard. And this is not, it's, you can of course make in many shapes and forms, but I decided for this one because I think it looked nice and I think it's easy to do. And it's if you give your mother one of these, I'm pretty sure that you can earn a lot of Minecraft time on the computer. So it's a good idea to do, or you have a sister, or if you are a girl that want one of these, we will make two ear for two for the ears afterwards when we finish with this one. My granddaughter want two for her, and they shall be hanging, she say, hanging from her ears. So but maybe we will make a star or something instead of this form, but whatever, we will get to that. The first thing you do, now I will see if I have done anything right. I think I have. The first thing you need to cut a slice of this, and I am telling you, that's not gonna be that. You have to work for this one. I did it. I have made a slice from this one, you can see, and polished it a little because it's kind of boring to see me stand and slice along. And for that you need one of these or a similar one. One of these. Wise, as you call it, I think, because it's very hard to saw in. It's like a saw in metal, but you just—it's not worse than sawing in tree, but it takes a little longer. And to do it right, you have to take your angle iron here and. Don't make it too thin, the slice. I have made mine very thin, but don't do that. But don't make it too thick either, because you're gonna sand it afterwards, and if it hard to saw in, then you can figure out it's also hard to sand in. See? You need a white color pencil. And I'm not gonna sew all this over because I'll just show you how. Now we have three cameras on, so it must be possible to find an angle that we can use. And now I'm of course standing away from the I cannot see it moves on the, it's because I have the wrong. See, maybe even tighter. See, now you can see, can you? And try to so now it focuses. And for that you use a iron saw. One of these. Some of your parents have one of these laying around. It's because it has very small teeth. And you can cut an iron with it. So, and the reason I made a stroke this way and one down this way is because when you are sawing it, you are both following the upper stroke and the stroke down there, because otherwise the slice will not be like you want it. But you can see it's not that hard. Try to stand so you kind of aim the blade after this, and this is down when you tilt it like this, right? And aim this way, and then, and it's not just do this, because when the iron saw, it's more like now. It's most forward motion that, but you can see it is you are able to do it, right? Just take your time and you will cut it nice and smooth, and you'll end up with one of these. And we will change. You'll end with one of these here. Flat ones here. This is the same thickness as this one. And then you make a triangle. I will put the measurement up on this one, but it don't matter how. It's not that precise. It's only what do you like and how do we want it to look, right? So, and this one you saw out as the on the same way as you did with this one, right? But I have a little machine, and this way it goes faster. So I will go over to that one, and you can see. And the problem here is I'm standing in the way of the light, but we can put some light, but it's a little difficult because the light kind of shines see, now I will make some noise. Got to do this because see, now I have the one on the one ankle. And now I take this one, put this one down again. Like this. There is a little wheel down here that the blade run up and down in. So, and so. Well, it was this one I wanted to see. I will go back to our place here. I'll take some sanding stuff here. Sorry for all the coughing, but see, when you polish this, and it's a good idea to polish it good before you start this, because it's the smaller it gets, it's harder it is to polish. So while you have a piece like this, then polish it fine. And start with this one here, is it, as you can see, not that way around. I will take, and you of course don't have a, I forgot that, you don't have a, I don't know, but I think you don't have a saw like I just used. So you will use this one, or you can use this one, or the one we used before, but this is, if you have, either one of them are good, so to cut one of these. And I will take, and now the camera is in the way with the long arm, so like this, the mouse over here. I'll take this one. So now, I don't hope it's upside down for you. There should be P240. That's the number of grain there are on the paper. So it's a little rough, but you start with that. And you take something to hold it with, because it's a little piece you have to work with. And take the other one. With this saw, you can if we had decided to make it, for example, hollow inside, we cannot do it with this one, then this here is the one you use, because you just drill a hole in the middle on this one, and then you loosen this, and you can put it in and then close again. Alright, but now we will sand it a little, so we get straight sides. The pointy stuff off. then it's a little. Maybe that's better with a little fire. I'll take it. And now we have to be a little bit careful because, of course, we can. We can break it now, even it's as hard as it is, because I want to have it more straight than this. Maybe I can take it bigger. I'll just to a start. See how it looks? Yes. See, now it's kind of a little tall on this one. But, and then we do all these edges are too sharp and so on. But you can see now we have one similar, nearly. We will get it more. And then we want to have done it such a piece in between here. And we will take this white stuff this time. And I will just saw a piece of this and see how we get along with that. How we managed to do that. So maybe we should make a stroke before, kind of like this. I will take a pencil, I forgot to take one in here. Thing to make something to follow when you draw. You will see how this behaves. I have never seen this before. join. And now we will see, because it got kind of thin. It's fine. We will change the camera again. And only a lot of time. I don't know where, but shall we make it exactly like this one? We will, or more or less. But see, just so I can make a stroke, because now we saw it over. We cut it. Over here because of the light, because it's very difficult to see anything on this. Oops! Don't do that. It slides around, man. So, I don't know if you can see anything, but there is a white stroke on it. And I was saw that one too. And remember to change the camera. Right. And the foot is too far down. See, now it gets a little tricky because it's so little. Let's see. Together. I think this sandpaper is too rough, so we will take something else. See, we have something here. The one here is 1200 grit. You can see here. Oops, 1200 grit. And this one should be 800 or 600 grit. So we will take the 600 now too. And this is the paper you, when you polish the flat one, where do we have our plate? Have we lost that in the fight for country? And where is our plate? We didn't use all of it. Oops, I cannot see. See, first 240, then 600, and then 1200 when you polish it up, but It takes a little time to do it, so have patience. And it's when it comes to everything. You need patience. I think this is... We can hold it against... The only way to see it, if you hold it against something you know that is... Because then you can see if any light slips through. Here it does. So... So it's very important that this lay on a flat piece of something. Because if this is not... Don't do like this, because then we don't get it flat. What about now? Now it's flat like a pancake. Okay. And now you can see, oops, I need something to see the fingers. Remember, it's not color, it's just dust, so it's easy to get off. It's not hard. Oh, but you have to clean the dust off. Good, because otherwise, the glue will not stick. And what glue are we gonna use? We are gonna use super glue. That's the best. Because that's thin like water and it hold fine to this. Like this. And then we need to have this piece in between. Right. Oops. Wrong way around or what? No. What's wrong now? Okay, it was me. Can you see, or am I too far out? Brrrt. You can see it's in this and it's too thin. You can probably not see what it is. So, like this. And if you use a piece of copper, you can use whatever you have that you think that is nice, but you just saw a piece of copper like I did this one, and with the iron saw, then everything is fine. Get up on the side. So now I need to go and get some glue. And now remember, when you are using super glue, you have to be careful, because you're gluing your finger together if you don't And when you want to take them apart, then there will be more skin on one finger than another. I'm just telling you, this is not so. Get here, it's okay with the parents. To help out. Then you can laugh at them when their hands are glued together. And there is nothing better than a laughing at parents. Now I have to be careful. It's not me. That's the laughing stuff here. I can see it's not, it's kind of not in line, but we will sand it so it is in line. I will take, and see now it's kind of stuck to the underpart. But that's okay, because we have a persuader. A very good persuader. We'll remove this one so I can get the persuader onto it. See, we will take one of these, see, and then you're kind of persuaded. Not try to get under it to lift it. Oops, now it's on the floor. I will go down and get it. You can see, maybe you should have heated a little more gentle, but that was just me. I will saw this piece off. Oops! Oh, it's not dry yet. We need to wait a little. We need to wait a little. I thought there was something I wanted to say. I have forgotten, so it cannot be important. I have another thing. You see what we are going to build after this? This is a board building boats set in wood. So that will be after we have made this one and a couple of earpieces. We will fit this one. Kind of. And one day we will build a flying machine with a motor. A really one. And not a real one, but a model, a big one. I know that everyone talks about drones these days, but There are a lot of drones on YouTube, so I don't have to do that. You will just put it on again here, just to the first couple of, and then I will just saw this one over. Yes, it is the right one. And scared something pulled down, so I did this. It broke again. But we glued again. Something fall down. I don't know what it is. It's when the machine start to. I will cut a piece now
before I glue it.
It's a little alert when you do stuff like this. So we have to do one more time, but then we have to get the glue off. It's because I was too early on it. So I'll just glue it and then, oops. Then we will let it be till tomorrow, because else we will keep breaking it. The glue has to harden, but you know, always in a hurry. How do this way? And hurry is not always a good thing. So you'll take it a little easy this time. So and remember, it's not the amount of glue that's on here. Stop it! Too violent. So we have to wait to tomorrow. But tomorrow we're back again, and we have had good sound on all night. And I know my golden voice, we cannot do anything about. It is what it is. So we have to live with that part. But all the tech stuff and hardware and software, we sometimes can do something about, but you know, all this setup is home-built stuff, so it's sometimes a little difficult. But when this is polished and dry, it will be very fine. Nope. It's kind of... This upper part is it. It's not down. It's okay. No, nothing is coming out of that. And when it rains, it pours. Hope that is better, because finish for today with that. And we will keep on tomorrow. Tomorrow we will finish this one. We only need to sand it and then drill a hole in it and then put some chain on. And these chains are bought. You can see there's a little log on here, and you can buy the log in loose and little rings you have in here. You can buy separate too, and then you can decide how long a piece of this you want to buy. But that you will see tomorrow, and you can get that in hobby stores. So, but I will say thank you for today, and hope you'll see, I will see you again tomorrow. And remember to subscribe on YouTube and follow on pixelfantasies.com, right? Thank you and goodbye.